Hey guys, I am Avinash here and welcome to OnLive Server. So today in this part 1 video of AWS LightSail, I will tell you a brief about its uses and importance, and later on in part 2 we will configure it with WordPress, load balancers and various other features which are provided in AWS LightSail. Okay, so before moving on to the practical part, I will tell you something about this important feature in theory. Okay, so let's move to our slide. So here you can see Amazon LightSail. Now here I will give you a brief description. See, in simple terms, we can define it as an easy way to launch and manage your pre-configured VPS, that is virtual private server, with AWS in few seconds. Now, before moving further, I would like to take you towards to the time when we created EC2. Now, at that time, you must be remembering that you have a freedom to decide various AWS components, like what AMI you want, what operating system you want to select, what EBS, how much EBS you want, what the security group you want to have. You can set your own static and public IPs. So it was a very time-taking procedure. Okay, but if you simply need a pre-configured system and you just want to run your applications on an inbuilt platform, then best option for you will be VPS. That is where everything is pre-designed, and it also it is also very cost effective, and it takes less time to start your work on VPS. But in this case, if you want to expand your development process, then option of scaling is very limited and is also very time taking. So AWS in their process of research, they kept all these things in their mind, and thus the issue of AWS LightSail came in the picture. Now, if you will ask me what is the advantage of AWS LightSail, then I will say that it has an ability to scale and integrate with other AWS services. And just remember that this is the best feature with which AWS LightSail provides us. Okay, so in our next slide, if you want a very simple definition, then I can say that AWS LightSail is just a normal virtual server that is very cost effective, fast and reliable, and also very user friendly. Now, AWS LightSail is very helpful for developers. Why I am saying this? Because with the help of LightSail VPS, powerful API and storage, speed and secure networking, it makes a best choice for developers along with load balancers. Now in this, you can see here you got many terms like what is secure networking, then load balancers, API, storage. So this all terms we will be discussing further in our part 2 and part 3 of this video. Okay, so this was just a basic definition where I told you that what is Amazon LightSail, what is the difference between when you are operating on an EC2 or when you are operating on an VPS. So in VPS, we felt that there was the need of scaling, you know, for the developers. So because of that issue, the picture of AWS LightSail came in light, and then we have this advantage. Okay, and this was a simple definition. Okay, so this is just a basic theory through which you can understand what is Amazon LightSail. Now let us move on to the practical part so that you can understand it more clearly. Okay, so you can see here, this is the AWS management console window. The reason I have selected is Mumbai. Okay, so now you can go and click on the dashboard. You can click on the services, and here in this compute option, you can see the second option is of LightSail. Okay, just click on this option. Okay, so this is just a window which is already running. So I will just stop it, and I would like to stop my instance. Okay, so see, this is the simple dashboard of AWS LightSail. Okay, and here you can see that we are getting different options like what are instances. You can select your databases from here. You can select the networking. Okay, in networking you are getting these three options, that you can create your own static IP, you can create your own DNS zone, you can create load balancers, you have an option of storage, you can create your own disk. you have an option of taking snapshots. What is a snapshot? This I will be discussing later on in some other video. Okay, now just go to instance. See, my this instance is stopped, and let me just delete it. Okay, so now when you will just click on Amazon Light Sale, then you will get this window where you will see it is written that you have no instances right now. Okay, and if you want to learn more, then you can just click on this link and you will get the PDF of this Amazon Light Sale service. So right now we will be creating on we will be clicking on this create instance option. Okay, so let me create. Okay, so see, this is the page which you will get on creating the instance. Okay, so the first option is instance location. Now you can see that my zone is already selected as Mumbai zone A, because at the time of creation of EC2 I had already selected my zone as Mumbai. You can change this zone from here. Okay, when you will click see, you got various zones like Mumbai, Singapore, Paris, and just remember this line. This is very important line. It is telling that the closer your instance is to your users, the less latency they will experience. So this is the only reason that whenever we try to create an instance or VPS or anything, we just select our nearest zone to avoid the latency issues. So right now I am selecting my region as Mumbai, and I'm okay. So here is my one message that you are creating this instance in zone A, Mumbai. Okay, now see, here it is asking that pick your instance image. Now image is like which kind of what kind of operating system or AMI you want to have on your instance. So here we are having like Linux option and Microsoft option. See, in Linux you are having like WordPress, you know. See, okay, you can select a blueprint also. What is the blueprint that you want? Only OS, or you want apps along with OS? So if you will select only OS, then you can see either you can have Ubuntu 16th version, Ubuntu 18 version, Debian, okay, CentOS you can have. Or if you want to go with Microsoft, then you can have Microsoft Server, Windows Server 2016, Windows Server 2012. And if you want to have this operating system along with other apps, then you can install SQL 2016 Express version, or in Linux you can have with along with app you can have WordPress or Joomla, you can have Magento, you can have LAMP, PHP 5, LAMP, PHP 7, Drupal. So whatever is your requirement, you can just simply select this image and you can just move further. So right now in this video I will be creating a Windows server. Okay, so I just click on this option. I want just only the operating system, so let us create 2012 version. So I'm clicking on this option. Okay, see, every option you click you get a small message where you can just read that whatever what is it happening. Okay, so here it is written that Windows Server is already integrated with the .NET to accelerate the development cycle. So this is very good feature which AWS provide. Otherwise, normally when you install the Windows Server older version, then you have to install this .NET framework in some of the older versions like 2008 version and nearby about. Okay, so the time of creation of instance, I selected my region, I selected my OS, that is image. Now see, here optional you can add your own launch script also, but this we will do it later. Okay, now see, you can choose your monthly plan, which is $8, $12, $20. Now the first month is free, so we are doing all this process on a free tier. You can see the specifications that what is the memory you are getting, 512 MB, processing speed of one virtual CPU, storage you are getting 30 GB, transfer rate will be 512 GB. Okay, so we are going with this plan. Now just move forward. You can identify your instance with, you can just name your instance, you can change this. Here you can select how many instances you want to create. So right now we are creating only one. You can add tags to your instances also. Okay, now you can add a key value to your instance. Now just click on create instance. Now after clicking on this option, you just have to wait for around about a minute or so. Now you can see I got a message that my Windows Server 2012 version with 512 MB RAM, one virtual CPU, 30 GB SSD is being created. Okay, see, this is my IP on which this instance is being created, Mumbai Zone A, and my status is pending. Okay, So let us see other options also before my instance get created. You can have database also. Later on I will show you that how you can create your database, like you want MySQL or PostgreSQL, whatever you want. You can just select your database plan, you can identify and continue. Similarly, like if we go back, okay, so similarly you can go to the networking option where you can just configure all these details. You can create the load balancer. In the part 2 of the video I will be telling you how you can create a load balancer on your HTTP as well as HTTPS websites, okay, that is secured and unsecured sites both. Okay, so let us go back and see what is the status of our instance. Okay, so right now here you can see that my instance is already in the running mode because earlier it was pending and now it is in the running mode. Okay, just click on this option. See, here you can get manage connect. It is like it is already connected. Okay, here from here you can manage, you can stop, you can reboot, or you can delete your instance. Now if you click on manage, see here you can see the various important informations, like see from here you can stop or reboot your instance. Instance means now we can say it is your Windows server. Okay, the status of our server is running. This is our public IP through which you can connect to the server. This is our private IP. Okay, now connect, you can connect it using RDP right now also, or here you can see this is the default username administrator, and from here you can get your password. Okay, so see right now our password is like this. Okay, so connect using your own RDP client. Okay, from here you can connect through the RDP client also, and right now just save this password. Okay, so I'm doing Control C, I saved this password, and let's connect this server. Just click on this C. Here you can see that it is connecting to your instance, and you just need this public IP if you are connecting through RDS. Okay, and here you can see the information about your server, like what is storage. You can see the metrics. Right now no data is available because we are not working on our server. Here you can set your networking, what is your public, you can create the static IP, firewall, this is all port numbers. You can take this snapshot, which is very much helpful in case of which is very much helpful if you want to have a backup of your server. Okay, here you can add your tags. Here you can see the history, that when you created, when you rebooted, or when your service was terminated, or any kind of history you can see here. And here you can just delete your instance. Okay, so right now just see. Okay, see, this is what this is. You can see our instance is now connected. Okay, automatically it is connected, and right now we are on our Windows server. See, okay, so just you can have anything, you can work here. So right now your server is ready to work. Okay, so let's close this, and or else you can just note your default username. You can have your public IP from here, and you can have your password from here, and you can also connect it through the RDP. So friends, here you saw that it was a very easy step to get create your own server through the help of AWS LightSail. And right now if you want to stop, then I'm just clicking on at the stop button. Okay, I want to stop my instance, and after a minute it will be stopped. Okay, so this was all about the Amazon LightSail, how we created. And in the second part I will tell you further options of creating static IP or creating load balancers, adding your WordPress, etc. Okay so you can't access an instance unless it is in a running state. Okay, so I will just go back, and I will just go to my home page and stoppings. Okay, so you can see the status is stopping, and now it is stopped. Okay, so my instance is stopped. Always remember, if you have no use of your server, then just kindly delete it, otherwise AWS will charge you. Okay, so thank you guys for watching our videos. Do comment down your queries, we will be happy to reply you back. And do like, share our videos, also do subscribe. Okay, and we will be coming very soon with part 2 of this video. Thank you, and have a good